you guys ever built a model, anything like there's model airplanes and there's model cars or something like this, right? Model Legos. Okay, so I did not build this, I borrowed it. But anyway, so there's parts like this, there's really big ones, right? Have you seen like, is it the Millennium Falcon, really big, that you make out of Legos? But other people build model cars and model airplanes. If you have anything like this, there's one thing that they all come with to help you build it. What does it come with? Instructions, right? Like if we took this all apart, we're not gonna do that coding, right? But if we took it all apart, we would probably need the instructions to build it back the way it needs to go, right? So instructions are really important because, well, without them, you're just not going to build it quite the way you need to. There's a story in the Bible about a guy who was given instructions. His name is Noah, right? God gave him instructions to build an ark, a big boat. And so Cody's got a picture for me, hopefully. Okay, so God gave him instructions. He didn't give him these picture. He didn't draw this out for him. He just told him. But he said, I want you to build a boat that's 450 feet long, 75 feet wide, and 45 feet high. So do you think you could do that with those instructions? That'd be pretty hard. That's bigger than a football field. That's big, big, right? But God asked Noah to do that. And the reason God asked him, at the time of Noah's life, God looked down on the world and saw that the world was evil and people weren't treating each other right. And he was sad for what the world had become. But he saw Noah and his family, and the Bible says that Noah was a righteous man and he walked faithfully with God. So God wanted to destroy the earth, but he saw Noah and said, this man walks faithfully with me and he's a righteous man, so I'm going to save him and his family. But the only way for him to be saved was to build this ark, because God was going to destroy the world. So he told Noah to build this big ark. Here, I'll read the, I give you kind of specs, but this is what it says in the Bible. This is how you are to build it. The ark is to be 450 feet long, 75 feet wide, 45 feet high. Make a roof for it and finish the ark to within 18 inches of the top. Put a door in the side of the ark, and make lower, middle, and upper decks. So how many decks were there? Three, right? Three different decks. And what did God tell Noah to put on that ark? Animals, right? Two of each kind of animal. So that's a lot of animals. And you've got little animals, probably can fit in those decks, and you've got the really big animals. Imagine the giraffes, right? How did they, there's probably a window, or maybe a sunroom. I don't know, pretty tall. But Noah had to get all those animals in there and all his family in there because God said it was going to flood, it was going to rain. So do you know when it was time to get on the ark, Noah got on the ark, all the animals, all the family, and then do you know who shut the door of the ark? Well, it'd be kind of hard to. But Noah could have, but God did. And the Bible says that God shut the door to the ark. He made sure everything was in, and he shut that door to make them all safe and sound, right? I mean, God said it was going to rain and it was going to flood. But you know the weird thing about that is up till that time, it had never rained. They didn't know what rain. Imagine if you never saw rain and God said it's going to rain and you went, what's that? I don't know what that is. But Noah had to believe God, right? Have faith in what he was saying. I don't know what rain is. I probably don't know what a flood is, but we're going to do this anyway. And that's what Noah did. He followed God. And it rained for 40 days and 40 nights. So imagine raining over and over. We just came up on the anniversary of the big, as we call around, the big flood at Chandler, Nazarene Church. That was a lot of rain, but imagine it raining for 40 days and not stopping. That's a lot of rain. And it flooded the boat, the ark, you know, the world was covered with water and the ark was just floating because everything else was destroyed. And then once the rain stopped, it took a lot of days for that flood to go down. It says 150 days. for the water to go down, and still they waited to get off the ark because the ground was still very wet. But God had a plan for Noah's life, and because he was faithful and he obeyed God, Noah and his family were saved. And do you know that God has a plan for our life? And we may not know what it is. Do you guys remember in Vacation Bible School we learned about God's plan? says, the Bible says, I know the plans I have for you, plans to prosper you, not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. So if we obey God and we follow his plan, we'll be successful too. Just like Noah, he was the only one that was faithful at the time, and God saved him and his family, and God will do the same for us. We do great things when we have faith and we trust in God. Let's pray. Father God, sometimes the plans that you give us are hard to follow, and we don't see how they can possibly come to light, but Lord, help us to remember that you are faithful, and if we follow faithfully and obey, Lord, we can do anything for you. In Jesus' name.